Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Richard Millett, pictured, has revealed he knew Jeremy Corbyn at the time he referred to British Zionists as having no English irony, and that the Labour leader knew he was Jewish. The Labour Against Anti-Semitism group has lodged an official complaint against Jeremy Corbyn after footage of him emerged saying British Zionists do not understand English irony. Speaking in 2013 at a London conference promoted by Hamas's propaganda website, the now Labour leader said British Zionists did not want to study history or understand irony, despite having lived in this country all their lives, Mail Online revealed last week. It has triggered a formal complaint from the anti-Semitism campaign group that claims the video clip is anti-Semitic and brings the party into disrepute, reports The Observer. The complaint comes as the blogger Mr. Corbyn claimed didn't understand British irony. Richard Millett told Mail Online he knew him at the time and was aware he was Jewish. In an exclusive video message, Mr. Millett, 50, said that he and Corbyn mixed in the same circles as they were both involved with the same television station. Corbyn knew me to say hello to me, he said. It's not like I was a stranger. He read my blog. He knew that I was British and Jewish. He was targeting me. Mr. Corbyn presented a regular program on Press TV, the Iranian government's mouthpiece, when he made the remarks in 2013. Mr. Millett was a commentator for the same channel, providing a rare pro-Israel perspective in the face of the channel's pro-Palestinian editorial views. Corbyn knew exactly what he was saying and who he was saying it to, he said. That's what made it all the more hurtful and anti-Semitic, a Labour source told The Observer. They were not aware of Labour Against Anti-Semitism's complaint, but a spokesman said, the Labour Party's complaints procedure operates confidentially in the interests of fairness to all concerned. This is to ensure protection of the personal data both for any members who make complaints, and for those to whom complaints relate. Therefore, we do not comment on individual cases. Mr. Corbyn has since said his use of the word Zionist was, in the accurate political sense and not a euphemism for Jewish people. He has also committed to being more careful with his language in future. Yesterday, Mr. Millett, whose father founded the Millett's chain of outdoor clothing stores, said Jewish people are scared on a physical level amid Labour's ongoing anti-Semitism crisis. Mail Online also revealed yesterday how another 2013 meeting, hosted by Mr. Corbyn, descended into chaos as police were called and a Jewish woman was called a piece of S asterisk asterisk asterisk. Mr. Millett said, these horrific, anti-Semitic events are ubiquitous unfortunately now in Parliament. They give them the veneer of respectability. These events have to be either stopped or very closely monitored for anti-Semitism. He also disclosed new details of the ironic remarks to which Corbyn referred. They were made by Manuel Hussassian, the PLO representative to Britain, at a pro-Palestinian event hosted by Mr. Corbyn in Parliament 3 days before, in January 2013. In a bizarre speech, recorded by Mr. Millett, Mr. Hussassian said, what an irony. How long are we going to suffer and be patient with Israel? You know I'm reaching the conclusion that the Jews are the children of God, the only children of God, and the promised land is being paid for by God. I have started to believe this because nobody is stopping Israel building its messianic dream to the point I believe that maybe God is on their side. Maybe God is partial on this issue. Mr. Millett took offense at the remarks, as he believed they suggested that Jews don't control just the Federal Reserve but now even God's money. He also felt that Mr. Hussassian was mocking Jewish culture. He exchanged views with Mr. Hussassian after the event. I'm supportive of Zionism and supportive of Israel, but foremost I'm British and I'm very concerned about anti-Semitism, he told Mail Online. Gideon Falter, chair of the Campaign Against Anti-Semitism, said, the fact that Jeremy Corbyn knew Richard Millett makes this incident even worse. From his privileged platform as an MP, he was using anti-Semitism to bully and abuse a Jewish member of the public. This rank anti-Semitic bullying would be the end of any other politician. Jeremy Corbyn must go. Pictured, Manuel Hussassian, the PLO representative to Britain, at a pro-Palestinian event hosted by Mr. Corbyn in Parliament 3 days before, in January 2013, where he made the famous, ironic, comments referred to by the Labour leader. Mail Online has contacted a Labour spokesman and Mr. Hussassian for comment. Earlier this week, Mr. Millett called Corbyn's words a racist comment and said he had implied Jewish people were not part of his Britain, The Times reports. Contrary to Mr. Corbyn's claims, Mr. Millett studied history at SOAS and specialized in the Middle East history and politics. His father Alan, a cricket fan who launched his company in southwest London and turned it into a thriving chain, while Richard Millett worked as a solicitor and then a journalist. Demanding a sincere apology, he said, "I wouldn't want to hear him say, 'I'm sorry if I offended you.' It's almost implying that I'm not English. Jewish people are not necessarily part of this English milieu that he has been part of. I am not part of his Britain. I am scared on a physical level, and the Jewish community is upset about what they see is happening. I think we are all scared." In the footage, Mr. Corbyn accused a group of British Zionists who had criticized Palestinian Ambassador Manuel Housassian after an earlier speech of having two problems. Speaking in 2013 at a London conference promoted by the Hamas's propaganda website, Mr. Corbyn said British Zionists did not want to study history or understand irony, despite having lived in this country all the lives he went on. One is they don't want to study history, and secondly, having lived in this country for a very long time, probably all of their lives, they don't understand English irony either. He said the speech had been dutifully recorded by the thankfully silent Zionists who were in the audience on that occasion. Mr. Millett was the only blogger covering the event. The Labour leader made the comments at a conference at Friends House in London's Euston. The event was advertised online by Hamas al-Qassam Brigades, which is designated a terrorist group by Britain, the EU, the United States and other countries. In one of the speeches, made by 9/11 conspiracy theorist Alan Hart, Zionism was described as a cancer at the heart of international affairs. It was also called a monster and compared to Nazi Germany. Several speakers were connected to Hamas. One called for attacks on the Royal Navy in the past and led a boycott of Holocaust Memorial Day. In a statement released on Friday evening, Mr. Corbyn said he had been defending the ambassador from what I thought were deliberate misrepresentations by people for whom English was a first language when it isn't for the ambassador. Mr. Corbyn said, "I describe those pro-Israel activists as Zionists, in the accurate political sense and not as a euphemism for Jewish people, and that is made clear in the rest of my speech that day. I am now more careful with how I might use the term, Zionist, because a once self-identifying political term has been increasingly hijacked by anti-Semites as code for Jews." His comments come as veteran Labour MP Mike Gapes claimed he will leave the party over Mr. Corbyn's comments. He branded him a racist anti-Semite and threatened to break away from Labour after being elected as its member for Ilford South in 1992. Jewish Labour MP Luciana Berger had earlier said that the video contained inexcusable comments, which made her feel unwelcome in my own party. Mike Gapes, left, has apparently indicated he is leaving the party, while Luciana Berger, right, slammed the Labour leader for his comments from 2013 at a London conference. She wrote on Twitter, "The video released today of the leader of ITUC Labour making inexcusable comments, defended by a party spokesman, makes me as a proud British Jew feel unwelcome in my own party. I've lived in Britain all my life and I don't need any lessons in history, irony." It has now been revealed Jewish delegates at next month's Labour Party conference will be given bodyguards as fears grow for their safety amid the raging anti-Semitism row that has engulfed Mr. Corbyn. Protection will even be offered to Jewish Labour MPs who have been the victims of abuse from many hard-line supporters of the party leader. The news follows more controversial footage of Mr. Corbyn being uncovered. A second video from 2013 shows a parliamentary meeting hosted by Jeremy Corbyn where Israel was described as evil and a Jewish woman said she was called a piece of sh asterisk asterisk. Unrest began when a British Jewish member of the audience complained that she had not been allowed to challenge the speaker's anti-Israel views. "You're trying to shut everybody else up in the House of Commons that we fought for," she said. Corbyn refused to accept her questions and tried to close the meeting. Then it descended into chaos. On the video, one woman cries, "The Holocaust issue, Jeremy. Why? Why do you do this? Why?" She then adds ironically, "I like Jeremy Corbyn." A Jewish woman is then seen complaining to a police officer that she had been called filthy names, and a piece of s asterisk asterisk asterisk, as anger spilled over.